In this example, we want to use Excel to continue the pattern shown in the list here, 3, 7, 15, 31, 63, and so on. Pause the video and take a moment to see if you can determine what the pattern is. There's more than one way to describe the pattern, but one way of looking at it is that to go from one number to the next, here starting at 3, we double that and then add 1. So double 3 and you get 6, add 1 and you get 7. So we're putting the preliminary numbers here into a column. Double 7 and you would get 14, add 1 and that's 15. Double 15 and you would get 30, add 1, that's 31, and so on. Now, in order to continue this pattern down to the 20th term, we want to use a formula to describe the pattern, and then we can use cut and paste to very quickly generate the rest of the terms in this sequence. So we're going to enter a formula by typing an equal sign. And the formula that we want here is going to reference the cell above. What we want in row 5 is the number above, which I will click on that, cell A4, multiplied by 2, so we're typing times 2, and then adding 1. So we have the formula equals A4 times 2 plus 1, and that should give us that next term, 63. Now to find the 20th number in this sequence, what we want to do is go back up to that formula, copy it, so we can right-click, choose copy, or you can do control C on the keyboard, and if I come down to the cell below and choose paste, right-click and choose the first option for paste, or use control V on your keyboard, and it has generated the next term, 127, and I can continue pasting on down below, and it continues that pattern. So every time it is referencing double the cell above and add 1. Now I'm using control V on the keyboard to do those paste operations. Now if I go ahead and scroll all the way down to where I want to go, 20, I can paste all at once into a large block, and I see that the 20th term in that sequence is 2097151. Now, one thing that we may want to do here is adjust that number format to make it easier to read. When you want to change the format of a cell, do a right-click on that cell, choose the option to format cells, and then we have several options. I'm going to go to the number format and tell it that I want to use the thousand separator. We're dealing with whole numbers here, so I don't want any decimal places. The pound signs here are showing that the number as displayed now is simply too large to appear in that column, so we're going to click up here, make that column wider so we can see it, and there now we can see it nicely formatted as 2,097,151.